We're going to mark chapter 12. Our thought this morning is the evil that you do. The evil that you do. And I heard a song that says, the good that you do will come back to you. And it don't cost you very much. It doesn't cost you much to do good to somebody, and you'll get blessed right back for doing that. But I want you to know that the evil things that you do, that's coming back to you too. So we have to watch how we treat people, how we do things against the will of God, because what you sow, you're going to reap. So, just like in our Sunday school lesson this morning, the people thought, well, we living all right, we ain't getting punished, and they not getting punished, and they sinning every day. Mm-hmm. Your time and in God's time. You may be doing all right now while you're doing your dirt. Uh-huh. But a change is going to come.
Right.
The evil that you do is coming back.
Full circle.
St. Mark chapter 12, beginning at verse 1, we're going to read down through verse 9, but we're going to talk as we read. And he began to speak unto them a parable. Uh-huh. A certain man planted a vineyard and set a hedge about it and did the place for the wine vat and built a tower and let it out to husbandmen, and went into a far country. And at the season, he sent the husbandman a servant, sent to the husband a servant, that he might receive from the husbandman of the fruit of the vineyard. And they caught him and beat him, and sent him away empty. And again, he said unto them, another servant. And at him, they cast stones. They wounded him in the head, and they sent him away, shamefully handled. And again, he said another. And him they killed. And many others, beating some and killing some. Having yet therefore one son, his well-beloved, he sent him also last unto them, saying, they will reverence my son. But those husbandmen said among themselves, this is the heir. Come, let us kill him, and the inheritance shall be ours. And they took him and killed him and cast him out of the vineyard. What shall therefore the Lord of the vineyard do? He will come and destroy the husbandman and will give the vineyard unto others. The evil that you do will come on back to you. The evil that you do. In the scriptures this morning, Jesus began to speak a parable because the priests and the scribes had asked him, on whose authority are you doing these things? Uh-huh. On who gave you permission to tell people to forgive each other? Uh-huh. To tell people to pray one for another? Who gave you permission to forgive sin? And Jesus began to speak to them in a parable about a vineyard owner. And said he planted a vineyard.
Yeah.
And he put a hedge around it. You know how we put our fences up. Right. Pastor preacher messed one time, good fences make good neighbors. Uh-huh. He put a fence around it. So you know we want a boundary around our property sometimes. Uh-huh. To make sure the animals can't get in there.
Yeah.
And other things. People can crouch in on our property. But the Lord had prepared the vineyard. He had built a wine vat so they can stomp out the grapes. He had built a tower so they'd hold the juice. Everything was prepared, and then he rented it out to somebody else, and he left. And if we look at the spiritual side of that, how the Lord has created the heavens and the earth.
All right.
And how he has called into being the trees and the animals and all these things of nature.
That's right.
He put the ocean around the United States, the heads of sin.
Yeah.
To protect his children.
Yeah.
And then he said, Sister Wallace, you go around there and run this part of the vineyard for me. Sister Rackley, you got that part. He written it out. This is not our world.
All right.
Amen.
We're just passing through.
Amen.
But while we're here, he said, occupy.
Yes.
So we have a responsibility to work this thing.
Yes.
To tell others of the goodness of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
He said, in due season, when he thought the fruit ought to be ripe.
Yes.
When I've given you time to preach my word.
Yes.
When I've given you time to teach, to show love, to fellowship, then I'll send for some of the fruit.
All right.
I'll see if you're paying your tithes and your offerings.
All right.
I'll see if you're praising and worshiping me.
Yeah.
The parable says, in the season,
yeah,
he sent one of the angels down. He sent a servant down to reap some of the benefits of the fruit.
Yeah, all right.
Instead of us church folk, praising and worshiping God, giving him his time, we beat up the prophet. We beat up the minister.
Yeah.
The evangelist that's coming through.
Uh-huh.
We don't want to hear what you got to say. We close the door in the face. But Jesus said, well, let me say no. See, you have different ministers in different churches.
Right.
You have evangelists from across the country.
That's right.
Coming to different places. You have prophets prophesying what thus says the Lord.
Yeah. Right.
And what you do? Time on fire, I'm gonna hit it. I can do what I'm gonna do. I'm grown.
All right.
Ignoring the messages God is sending to repent and be ye baptized. Straighten up and live right. The Sunday school lesson said, return to a just God. Repent.
Yeah.
Live right. That's all I'm asking you to do.
Yeah.
If you have rented out my property,
all right, now.
I'm allowing you to stay here.
Uh-huh.
The very least you can do is offer me up some mustard oil.
Right.
Give me a little of that great juice you made. From that wine? Just a little bit. All you require to the tent.
Right.
And we know that in our lives we have different people coming in to preach. We hear about revival over here. We hear about an evangelist over here. And we'll run and follow them.
Uh-huh.
But the minute they step on our toe,
uh-huh,
I ain't going back over there.
Uh-huh.
Mm-mm. And you know what else we do? We go lying on them.
Uh-huh.
I saw him coming out of the motel. Well, he got to live somewhere while he in town preaching.
Come on.
But we didn't tell that. Yeah. We just said, oh, I saw him coming out of the motel on that. Well, was he dressed up? Did he come out by himself? It ain't even none of your business. So not only are we ignoring the word of God, but we have beat the reputation down. Just because you stepped on my toes. Just because I felt like he was talking about me. This is prophesying. This is where Jesus talked to him in parable. And he said, multiple, the scripture says, some they killed, some they stoned, some they, you know, just many of them. And in my lifetime, there have been many ministers and prophets and teachers and evangelists and pastors come through. And reputations have been torn up and torn down by that tongue. Different things that we are doing. You better get your mouth off.
Preach.
Whether male or female. judge not. Hallelujah. The scripture says that God said, but I have one servant, beloved. A loving, I'll send him. For surely, they'll reference my son. Surely. See, we people in these United States of America, I ain't talking about nowhere else. I'm talking about these. We think that we are the Israelites. That we are the chosen ones.
All right.
We think that we have a right because we're well educated, because we have been blessed financially, because we have positions and statuses of this world. We think we can do what we want and get away with it.
Right.
We think that, y'all.
All right.
I can look at you and tell by the way we walk, the way we turn our nose up at people, the way we treat people, that we think that we're better. And if you are a true child of God, you are somebody in Christ Jesus.
That's right.
But children of God know to be humble.
Yeah.
And they don't boost and boast themselves up. Except they be telling you about the goodness of the Lord.
Yeah.
See, we are nothing but filthy rags, except God has said something different.
Yeah.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So we have the nerve, if you look at the parable, the owner of the vineyard fixed everything up. You know how a landlord will have a rental property. And the landlord takes care of every little thing that breaks down. But he's got everything fixed right. Some people already have furniture in the rental house.
That's right.
That's what Jesus did for us. He fixed it up so that we have everything we need. All we got to do is live. Occupy. And then the husbandmen, the people that, the renters, had the nerve not to want to pay rent. How in the world can you rent something, use up everything there? I'm sleeping in the bed, I'm cooking in the kitchen, I'm out there making me some wine, I'm a good break, I'm doing everything I want to do. And in the first of the month, time to pay rent. And I ain't gonna pay. And you better get away from here. That, see, the Lord has been putting in my spirit. Stop sugarcoating. Stop doing them feel-good messages.
All right.
And tell my people to straighten up and fly right.
Yeah. My God.
And so I'm telling you, first it comes to me,
right.
I have to eat.
Amen.
Because the role is being called, y'all. Amen. It's been being called ever since I've been alive.
Yeah.
But it seems like they fast reading now.
Yeah.
It's coming. And if we want to stand and hear him say, well done, this evil we're doing, intentionally doing things, and then hide our hand and pretend we, I don't know nothing about it. What? For real? I can't lead church folks, then that you doing it.
Amen.
And we better stop. We better stop.
Amen.
How dare you, when the owner come back, you slam the door in his face. The earth belongs to the Lord.
Yes.
That's the authority he has to do what he wants to when he get ready to do.
Yeah.
It belongs to the Lord. It's his. He has just loaned it to us as caretakers.
Thank you, Jesus.
And are we taking care of his vineyard? Are we seeing after his fruit? Are we seeing after one another?
Yeah.
And making sure that everybody have what they need. Because the scriptures tell us we can have our needs and our desires met.
Yeah.
But we're not even meeting each other's needs.
Uh-huh. Right.
And call ourselves Christian. That evil stuff that we do, they better get it the best way they can. Get it like I got mine. Selfishness in the house of the Lord.
You have to fix that thing.
I've heard about fights in the house of the Lord.
Lord.
I've heard about arguments and weapons taken inside the house of the evil that we do. Evil. That's just wrong, y'all. It's just wrong. Hallelujah. He said, I said, my beloved son, surely they'll reference him. And all I'm asking for is my just due. I owned it and I loaned it to you. And all I ask is a little bit of their hearts.
A little fruit.
All right. Little fruit. And you know it has to be a huge vineyard. If he don't deal a big bat, put a head around it. He is protecting us from the enemy, and we are benefiting, and we don't want to give back to God.
Amen. Amen.
Remember the parable about the man building barns?
Right.
He had so much that his barn was full. He said, I'll build me some more barns. I can stock it up. He said, nothing about being through the neighbor. Making sure your neighbor had a piece of bread. They will reverence my son, my only son, my beloved son. And he sent his son unto the world. Hallelujah. And just like in the parable said, the husband said unto himself, this is the heir. And then it'll be ours. Because won't nobody be here to inherit this world, this earth, this land, this vineyard. So when an old man dies, it'll be ours. Jesus came. Wrong answer. Jesus was sent into the world so that I may have a right. That I may gain eternal life.
Yeah.
And all I'm thinking about, I want to be in charge. So I ain't listening to nothing he said. Let's crucify him. Crucify him. So that I can be the head. So that I can tell. Well, Lord, Sister Wallace, I didn't do that. Every time you misuse one of his, every time you lie, every time you steal, every time you cheat, every time you commit sin, you said, crucify him because I don't believe you.
Right. All right.
He's still dead. He didn't raise from him. He wasn't raised from the grave.
Crucify.
Every time. As Deacon Hopkins said in his meditation, you got the hammer in your hand. You know, we quit to judge Judas. Oh, I can't believe Judas will walk with Jesus and he did that. Do you hate Judas? Because every time we do something, we do it. Turn our back on. We turn him in. We say it's like, hammer in my hand. I'm the one nailing him to the cross. Every time I'm in disbelief, that I say, no, that can't be. Ain't no way he can cure my headache. Oh, ain't no way he can cure my cancer. That was the medicine. Doctor did.
Yeah, yeah.
That thing come back on you.
Amen.
See what the doctor gonna do. Don't you know if the doctor don't know nothing except God say yes and amen? Yeah,
all right.
That's it.
Surely they'll reference my son. Or by the evil that you think of. See, some people sit around day in and day out trying to figure out how they can get over on somebody else.
Amen.
How they can get by. You spend so much energy trying to get out of doing real work. You could have been a dead task and through it. But you trying to figure out how you can get away. Well, that just ain't safe. don't think that's safe. I don't think that ain't in our contract. We're supposed to do that. Or that's somebody else's job there. And the number of people that sit around on these computers trying to get your identification. You just go out and get your real job working on computers. If you like working on computers, get your legal job. How you gonna say, this is the heir to the vineyard? Let's get it. So that we can own it. Well, if he done built everything, got it just right, and he just told me all I had to do was go there and work the vineyard and reap it. And he sent back for a jar of jelly. That's all he asked for, a jar of jelly. You got it made in the shade. He ain't nowhere. He, the scripture says he went to a far country.
Right.
He done left. No. That means you can do anything you want to on this land. Just send him a jar of jelly. God has given us the same opportunity. He left us here to work the harvest. Somebody said the harvest is plenteous. It's plenty to do. Plenty of fruit to be had. All you got to do is work it. Work it. But instead, you're trying to figure out how I can own it. I don't want to just keep working. But if you reaping all the benefits, what's the difference? It's yours. What's the difference? I want to own it. So I got to come up with some evil. Evil. Praise God. That ninth verse says, what shall therefore the Lord of the vineyard do? Will he come? He will come and destroy. That's that evil that you do. It's coming back to you. You may be getting by, but you won't get away.
All right.
He's coming back on you. He will destroy the husbandman and give the vineyard to another. Take what you got and give it to somebody else. And see, that's the way we are every day. Every day the Lord has blessed us. Instead of us using it for good, we come thinking of some evil to do to somebody else. Or we just, by nature, are doing evil tricks, digging ditches, sticking our foot out to trip somebody up. And woe unto you, before long, what you got gonna belong to me. Keep digging ditches for me. Keep digging them ditches for me. You don't mess with God's children. But if that's what you get pleasure out of, digging ditches, keep digging. Better dig too. Because not only will God give me your ditch, but he'll bless me with more ditches. So that, hallelujah, the evil. Hallelujah, we don't want evil to come back on us.
All right.
Again, the stuff that you suffer, you going to reap. You might not reap the same day. You might not even reap the same year. But before you leave this world, it's coming full circle. Because the word said it's in the Bible that you're going to read it. And I ain't got no better sense than to believe Genesis and Revelation. And all that stuff in between that God has given us. Because I've seen so much of it come true. I have seen so much of this come true. And they said, that's old folk. That's the Old Testament. Our Sunday school lesson this morning was prophesied in the Old Testament. Mm-hmm. It came true in the New Testament. Right. And it's still true for us today. It said, return.
Yeah.
Return. So today you better turn from them evil ways. Uh-huh. Trust God to get you through whatever. When God opens the door, it's open. But just the opposite, when he closed it, it's closed. And then he said something different. He said, I am the Lord and I change not. Praise God. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Yeah.
Amen. The evil that you do. You need to know that. You need to know that the evil stuff that you do, you need to stop. You need to repent. And repenting means I'm godly sorry.
Amen.
And I will not do that again.
Right.
But you need to acknowledge that it was wrong. And so the daily prayer, Lord, if I have offended, Lord, if I've done anything against your will, because sometimes you don't know you've offended and you don't know that you've turned somebody else away. So include in your prayer, Lord, if you didn't acknowledge that, Lord, I just went wrong. And I need to get back and tell her that I'm sorry. I misunderstood, or I didn't say that right. It didn't come out right. I didn't mean what I said. And if there's anybody else that I've offended, Lord, reveal it so that I can get right with you. Because I ain't trying to end up in hell for the rest of my life. Hallelujah. You need to know that the evil things, and when those thoughts come in your mind, you need to shake them off.
Yeah.
If you dwell on something too long, it becomes a part of you. Convince yourself, this is what I'm going to do. And next time, it's not going to come to me like that. Shut that stuff off. It's not worth it.